Virtual reality and augmented reality, VR and AR, are two of the hottest topics right now in the world of high tech, and Israeli companies are at the forefront. I visited with one recently in Jerusalem to see how they're bringing the Bible to life in stunning detail, and all on a headset. Take a look. Well, John, we know that Israel is a booming high-tech powerhouse. We talk about it frequently here on the show. Now, one of the things you're doing at Yaturu is virtual reality and augmented reality, VR and AR. You're doing some very cool stuff. You're talking about immersing yourself in a different world. But what you're doing is you're taking us 2,000-3,000 years in the past to ancient Israel. Tell us a bit more about it.
So what we try to do is we try to connect tourists to the location that they're standing, where in some cases it's not so easy. So let me give you an example. If we look at a place like the City of David, which is an amazing site with thousands of years of history, we take our tourists to the ancient palace ruins of King David and King Solomon. So it's an amazing site, but if you look at it today, it's actually, as it says, it's a ruins. It's really hard to visualize that this was once the place where King David used to rule from. We take them back into the real, how it used to look and how it used to be, and to visualize, to help them really understand what, where they're actually standing, how it used to be, and the power it used to have.
And this will be a group of people, John. You have 10, 15 people there.
Yeah, of course. So like we do group experiences and also individual experiences as well. On top of that, we don't just stop at the architecture. We also like to tell stories and to get people to connect to the history of the location. In the palace ruins, we start with King David and his young son Solomon, and they're talking about building the temple and all the drama and the tension surrounding those events. And so when a person then takes off the device, they can then really have a deeper appreciation of where they're standing, and basically they can take what they know from before, like the stuff that they know from the Bible from other places, and also link it to the place where they're at and really, you know, touch them.
You have the City of David, obviously. You also have segments from the Western Wall. And where else?
And we also have one of the overlooks of Jerusalem, the Amon Nativ Overlook, which we have with the one route. You start there, you're seeing the Jerusalem from far, almost a similar view to what we're seeing over here. Yeah. And we tell people about the story of Wesley, where they're at, where they're actually located, and to give people a bit of understanding about the map and the structure of where they're standing, but also the amazing events that they're seeing in this amazing panorama. Yeah. And then we tell the story of Abraham and go on all the way to the history until we get to the City of David as the next location, where we add on to that. And then we finish up at the Kotel area and tell the story of the Second Temple.
You're seeing the heroes of the Bible. You're seeing Abraham, King David. It's amazing. Sure. Okay, time for the big test. Sure. As I said, I'm not so tech savvy, but it's so easy to work. You and I were kind of messing around with it a little bit before the interview. So I'm going to put this on. And this is going to take me to the City of David, I guess 2,700 years ago, maybe?
Yeah. Definitely. Is and you'll meet our virtual guide there, Maya. She's actually an Israeli girl. She's a local native here, a 10th generation Jerusalemite.
Okay.
And she's the person there that will help you through the experience and take you through the digital world.
So she's my virtual tour guide. And
an
there's
amazing
Maya.
Palace, right?
Here we go, back in time.
How amazing does it look now?
Wow.
That's King David and his son Solomon.
Father, does it not disturb you that you'll never see the temple raised? After all this work and preparation?
I would have given anything to lay the stones myself. But God has decreed the temple must not be raised by my blood-stained hands.
And at the center of the vast kingdom stood the temple, a beacon of light for Israel and all nations. As it is said in the Bible about Solomon's temple, "For my house will be called a house of prayer for all nations."
Over here is the Western Wall, the last remaining retaining wall of Herod's temple complex. And that is Robinson's Arch. But this is what it looked like 2,000 years ago. Look around you.
John, all I can say is wow. I think the first thing that strikes me is the amazing detail to see inside. I've been in the City of David many of times. People have seen it here on the show many times. But to see it come alive in such extraordinary detail and transport us almost 3,000 years ago, absolutely amazing. You can tell that you guys really spent a lot of time on just the most minute, important details.
Definitely. We spent a lot of time with also like going through all the history books and all the archaeology and all the things just to make all those details right.
Yeah.
So it has that real authentic feel to it.
Groundbreaking stuff. John, you're on the cutting edge, man.
Thanks.
Thank you so much. We really appreciate
it. Thanks for having me.